So you guys know the Chevy Colorado and the Colorado ZR2, and specifically the new Bison that's coming. Those are mid-sized trucks that are made for off-roading, but what if that's not enough? What if you needed some more? Well, Mark Dickens is here. Mark, thanks for joining.
Thank you.
And what do you have here? I mean, these are special parts which you can add to your ZR2. Or Bison, right?
Right. Yeah, so, you know, when we brought back the Colorado into the midsize truck segment, one of the things we knew is our customers are going to want to take the truck off-road. So we came up with the ZR2. And the ZR2 has this capability that gave it ability to go desert running as well as rock climbing, you know, with the locking axles and the DSSV dampers. And so what we're really trying to do is listen to our customers and come up with parts and accessories that take that vehicle even further down each of those roads. So this list of parts and all these parts on these parts boards are actually parts that were designed and developed to do desert racing. These are the exact parts, exact design of hardware that Chad Hall has raced out in the desert in the Best in the Desert series.
And you're participating in that in 2019, or you have been already?
Yes, we have.
And you're continuing that development or just racing in general?
That's right. And you know, you and I have talked about accessories and performance accessories, designed, engineered, tested, and backed by Chevrolet. This is kind of a different approach. Our validation for these parts was actually Chad Hall's race truck. We actually ran over 10,000 miles in the desert with these parts. Doesn't use like a normal validation schedule that we do at our proving grounds. Actually bolted them on the truck and ran them. And for the first time for Chevrolet, you can actually buy the entire set of parts that built his race truck.
So let's go over some of this. This is kind of the rear of the truck, right? Rear axle?
Yeah, this is the rear side of it. So as you know, the dynamic spool valve multi-matic dampers, that's kind of the trick piece on the ZR2 pickup. What we have is we actually came out with a full race version of the same damper. For those that we know are gonna actually compete in off-road, this is something they're gonna really want. And really what we did was we increased the rod diameter on these, as well as increased the travel. And it's a specific tune in the damper that's was actually tuned by Chad Hall himself.
Okay. So this is not the factory piece that comes on a ZR2.
That's correct.
So this is something else. And by the way, at the end of the video, can you just say what everything costs?
Sure.
Right? And are these parts available like now? Or?
Yeah, we just announced at SEMA that these are ready for sale. And the pricing is just coming out in a couple days.
Okay.
And fundamentally, the list of the actual component set is kind of mix and match. You don't have to buy everything. You can actually use like just the shocks, you can use the springs, you know, it's kind of as your budget grows, you can actually put more of the truck together. So kind of, yeah, the rear suspension, you know, we actually, one of the neat things is we have Brian Cadella, one of the off-road experts, came up with he's spent 30 years designing leaf springs and getting the stresses down on leaf springs. We were able to actually pick up an additional 2 inches of travel with this leaf spring design. And this is something we think our customers are going to want, more wheel travel in the rear. But really one of the coolest trick pieces that's almost it's almost unfair is these jounce shocks.
Okay.
This is an additional shock absorber, if you think about that nature. It doesn't travel, it's not connected to the rear axle. So normal ride travel down the road, it's not touching. It's only under those really big hits. Like if you come across something unexpected, mm-hmm. Like if you ever going down a dirt road and all of a sudden
a whoop
out of nowhere, and yes. you don't want to stab on the brakes, that's when something like this comes into play. It contacts about halfway through the suspension travel. It'll actually contact the axle, and the amount of energy it can absorb, and it drives that energy back into the frame and dissipates that energy. And it really makes it like things that you think that's going to knock your teeth loose actually come out very, very smooth.
So it mounts to the frame here, just bolt on, really, right?
That's right. Yeah.
And then here's the kind of these leaf spring perch kind of contacts right here, right?
Yeah, right. That's the touchdown pad for the jounce shock. And I think the bolt-on effect is something we wanted to make certain. We knew a lot of our customers don't really want to weld on their frame. We wanted all this stuff to be something you could bolt on into your garage.
All right, so really quickly, what's this piece then, the crossbar?
So if you think about one individual wheel hit, maybe right rear, you drive it way up. We thought that if you tie the frame rails together, this allows the stress to be distributed across the frame rails. So this actually just crosses across both rear frame members.
And this is a pretty beefy piece.
Right.
All right, well, let's check out what else you have.
Okay. So if this is more rear suspension stuff. One of the things, when you start getting the long rear leaf springs like that, you get a lot of axle wrap. And what the team's designed is what we call a third member. It actually bolts to the rear axle, and it controls the axle rotation, or that what you'd call a wrap up. And so this bar goes across the frame. This one ties back to the rear differential. And this is a billet aluminum differential cover, and this is where all this bolts to on the rear axle.
So it prevents the axle from moving.
Mostly from that wrap up, like when you're coming out of a wash basin or something like that, and you start get that power hop.
Yes.
This keeps that wrap, that rotation under control. So then also we have a steel drive shaft. The ZR2 has an aluminum drive shaft. And one of the things we noticed when you're out and you hit those unexpected big rocks, desert running, or actually even rock crawling, a steel drive shaft gives you that extra layer of protection. And then this is a body lift kit, an inch and a half body lift kit to get the extra clearance, get a little bit larger tires if you want.
Okay. And racing components, this is all has been on the truck.
Yes.
On the racing truck.
This is the same content, same parts, same exact design that Chad has raced with. But you know, one of the things too, because the ZR2 has that capability for rock crawling as well, and the announcement of the Bison program that we have right now, we think a lot of the folks that are going to go out and do rock crawling, some of the stuff's going to be of interest to them as well.
Alrighty, finally in the front. Let's look at the front. Oh, by the way, this is the truck, right?
That's right. Yep, that's Jazz's okay. Truck right there.
Okay. So what's going on here? I mean, I see the other DSSV damper here.
Yeah, so this is same thing in the front. We picked up 15% more travel in the front suspension, adjustable spring perch, larger rod diameter, and this tuning again is tuned specifically for desert running. But now we know there's going to be customers that don't really want to spend the money on a set of dampers or take off the DSSV dampers that come on the ZR2, or maybe they're going to go overlanding or rock crawling. So we knew that they might want that additional suspension travel, so
without
the expense of the dampers.
Okay.
And in that case, we came up with an additional lift kit. And this lift kit is two pieces, and it goes in two locations on a stock standard DSSV spring and shock assembly. And half goes underneath the spring seat, half goes underneath of the mount to the body.
Okay.
And what that does is, because this is a position sensitive damper, there's a bypass port in here. And what you got to do is make certain that when you lift that front of the truck, you get that back in the right location.
Okay. I see. So, I mean, like you said, you can mix and match some of these components. You don't have to buy everything because, I mean, these dampers are quite a bit more than the factory ones or the stock ones, correct?
Yeah, that's right. Because there's a lot that goes into these. These are hand-built, custom-made by Multimatic. And Multimatic, as you know, three Formula One championships, same technology, not a deflected disc. It's a spool valve damper. Really high fade resistance. These things can actually take a lot of heat without fading.
All right, and what else do we have here? There's a jounce?
Yeah, same thing, jounce shocks for the front suspension. This goes in place of the factory jounce shock.
Okay.
It actually reacts to the lower control arm. We have an upper control arm with a high angle ball joint. So this goes actually to 35 degrees of ball joint travel. And this is one of the key enablers to getting the additional front suspension travel, the 15% more travel than a ZR2 factory.
And what's this here?
Front half shaft. This is a really cool piece. This is a splined half shaft. Inside of this body right here is actually splines, very similar to these ends, that travels inside of here. So you can actually extend and contract this. Okay. When you start getting in the long suspension travels, this gives you the ability to not pull the shafts, the CV boots and the joints apart. Mm-hmm. It actually articulates in this area right here. So that gives you a better steering feel, it gives you a better NVH, and a lot stronger, and it reduces the temperatures in the CVs themselves.
Okay.
There's one other thing I'd like to show you. These tie rod sleeves. One of the things we see when you go rock crawling, and sometimes in desert racing, when you hit the unexpected thing, there is a designed-in pinch point in the actual tie rods to protect the steering gear. Uh-huh. So they're actually designed to bend. These tie rod sleeves actually go over that area and drive them up to a higher level.
Okay.
And there's actually a lot of engineering. It looks like just a standard piece of steel.
Okay.
But this is still designed, and what it does is it cuts into that safety factor. It's still designed to bend before you break the steering rack. So if you're out crawling and you make that unexpected mistake, this will still allow a bending in there. before you break your actual steering gear and don't find yourself stranded out in the middle of nowhere.
Oh, very cool. So how do people get this stuff, and when is it available, and can you share any cost or numbers here?
Yeah, so the actual parts themselves were available through your Chevy Performance dealerships.
Okay.
You know, the Chevy Performance catalog?
Right, right.
And online.
Okay.
You can look up the background and all the part numbers. The actual cost of the parts, all-encompassing. And then the shock absorbers do carry a little bit more of an expense. Mm-hmm. About $3,000 an axle, $3,200 an axle.
Okay.
But if you were to do every single part of this, you're about MSRP around $23,000.
Okay.
And that's all the parts besides a roll cage that Chad Hall has in his race truck.
So you can build your own racing truck by getting a ZR2, adding these parts. Well, there's some more safety, right? The roll cage like you said, and maybe some lights.
Fuel cell.
Yeah, radios and stuff like that. And then can build yourself a racing truck, or you don't have to build yourself a racing truck. Maybe you're just a weekend truck,
right? And maybe you work your way up. You know, start with the Jown shocks. Maybe you get high travel front suspension, and as you get more money, you can grow with you.
All right. Well, thanks a lot for talking about this.
Thank you.
All right. And guys, go back to tfltruck.com for more news, views, and real world truck reviews.